President Rodrigo Duterte again blasted the Department of Public Works and Highways for alleged corrupt activities of its officials. The president, however, spared Secretary Mark Villar, who heads the agency.
Secretary Villar, marami pera, hindi ang kailangan mga urakot. Ang problema sa baba, malakas pa rin hanggang ngayon. Kaya nga sa mga project sa baba, yun ang laro dyan.
The Commission on Audit stressed in its 2019 report on the DPWH certain irregularities such as overpricing of projects totaling 431 million pesos which should be returned by contractors back to government. Among the 184 overpriced projects cited in the audit report was the drainage rehabilitation of Katipunan Street in Marikina City, overpriced by more than 5 million pesos. Government auditors also cited delayed completion and non-implementation of projects amounting to 101 billion pesos. Amid allegations of corruption, Secretary Villar inspected the China-funded 1.4 billion peso Pantaleon-Estrella Bridge connecting the cities of Makati and Mandaluyong.
Ito makaka-decongest sa EDSA, pati sa Guadalupe. Bahagi po ito ng EDSA decongestion ni President Duterte.
Villar asserts corruption allegations are being addressed by the Task Force Against Graft and Corruption, which he created through a department order.
We're looking at some complaints. So, investigan namin lahat ng complaints. We'll be even more aggressive. Ngayon at may task force, talagang mas lalo namin tututukan.
Let's give them a chance dahil sa aking pagkakaalam, talagang this is one of the rare moments na ina-address natin ang corruption dyan sa DPWH.
The DPWH said that while there is truth to some of the allegedly overpriced and delayed projects, some of the cost adjustments are justifiable.
Meron naman kasing adjustment in price. For example, nagkaroon ng armed conflict dun sa area. Then, mas mahal yung pag-transport ngayon ng mga construction materials. But if ito po ay hindi justified at meron pong overpricing, then kami po mismo yung magsasabi po sa inyo.
The DPWH stresses that despite controversial projects, the department has so far implemented 2.2 trillion pesos worth of projects under the Build program of the administration. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.